Moving on, last year, a number of protests were held against coercive conversion after a 27-year-old woman was killed while she was held captive at secluded recreational lodge in South Korea. The woman was later found murdered, with parents held responsible through suffocation. It led to a widespread worldwide demonstrations. Coercive conversion is reportedly chapels to find out more.
There was a young woman in Korea who was the victim of something called coercive conversion. Now, this forced conversion is a practice that is happening not just there but around the world, whereby victims are actually forcibly caused to change their religion. Now, unfortunately, in this instance in particular, the result was that this victim lost her life. And there's also been another case recently where somebody, a woman in the UK, was also murdered because of her change in religion. This case in particular that's happened in Korea has actually not been reported. So the death occurred about a year ago. And unfortunately, this sad incident was something that happened at the hands of the victim's parents. So it's actually the parents that enlisted in this conversion program, which caused this young lady, aged 27, to be taken to a place of confinement, where she was forcibly caused to convert her religion. But because she didn't want to, then what ended up happening was she lost her life through asphyxiation. Now, the sad reality is, through this past year, since this incident happened, actually this has not been broadcast within Korea. It has, however, been broadcast through the help of the HAC around the world, because these instances are things that should be made known and should be stopped at every effort.
As a result of that, what's the situation? What's been done?
So currently within Korea, unfortunately, there is no action being taken. This is really the sad reality of the matter, because there are many instances that are continuing to occur. About 150 were reported within Korea last year, and there are many instances in other countries around the world. So really there is a need for this to be known by the public so that action can be taken. So, for example, in Japan, in the UK, in the US, in Germany, there have been rallies held everywhere, actually, in order to make this known, to raise awareness so that it can be stopped. And through this, there are more and more people being made aware of the situation so that these things can be put an end to once and for all.
Are you frustrated in the lack of movement by Korea?
Absolutely. I would expect from a developed country that really there should be more action taken to stop these things.
Does our government need to do more?
I certainly believe that within the UK there is also a need for the human rights of its citizens to be protected. And I think we can see this even within the UK, as there was an incident not long ago, in November last year actually, where a mother of five children was very tragically killed because of converting from Hinduism to Islam by her former husband. So these situations we can see are not exclusive just to Korea, but they're happening around the world. So within the UK as well, there is definitely a need for the protection of the human rights of the citizens.
It's a bit of a worrying sign, isn't it? I mean, we've had situations like this. Most known in recent times might have been the Myanmar killings.
Absolutely. I think especially in this day and age, there is an expectation that these things would really be protected. The human rights of the people, global citizens, should be protected, especially in the developed countries. Now, ethnic cleansing, such as what you mentioned, is certainly a worry. Especially within the UK, there are also situations where there are children who are being subjected to cleansing because of their religious beliefs, which are also something that they have been brought up with outside of their control. So these instances, while there are many that are different levels of awareness, they are actually very relevant and something important that we should take into consideration to change.
What's the next plans now after this? What are the plans in place now to continue to make sure your voice is heard?
We're continuing to raise awareness by broadcasting and by making public these stories of these forced conversion situations. And we're gathering together with the families, with the relatives, and with many people around the world who also have a passion to make these human rights known and enforced through various means. At the moment, raising awareness primarily through these channels, but also with a view to hopefully creating and enforcing laws that can protect the rights of these people.